Check this out. It's a straight line mechanism for 3D printer bed movement. This is a bed platform, and this is suspended on 6 cables, all on its own unique angle. And you would think that it would swing around like a swing. With any fewer than 6 cables, it would. The 6 cables, it's tied in place. So, look. And our 6 cables come off the corners through a roller mechanism to one winch that combines our 6 of them. And they're tied off together here. And then they're wound up onto this contraption. What is it? It is a winch that winds up different amount of cable as it goes to compensate for non-linearity of having the cables at an angle, right? And also on the side of the winch comes a cable that goes down, around, and up. And right here, I would put my motor for motorizing it. Right now, I haven't gotten that far yet. I'm still performing some tests. You can see I bolted a down indicator here. Anyway, so let me show how it moves. Yeah, I have tied off a little bit. Okay. So it moves up and down in a straight front line because all the cables maintain accurate lengths because they're literally tied together. I should use probably much thicker string, like maybe 2 times or 4 times thicker, because it's a pretty big build. It's 50 centimeters on the side. So, yeah, let me tie it off again. I have a little tie point here. And, well, this is the spring is used anti-backlash spring. The idea is that this printer, because it isn't perfect, so you need an anti-backlash spring. But anyway, let me show how rigid the mounting is. You can knock on it, it don't go anywhere. If I push hard enough, at some point, some will lose tension, but up to that point, not going anywhere. This is just some excess cable. You always need to leave a little extra in case you miscalculate something. So yeah, it's actually surprisingly rigid. And I was testing rigidity with this dial indicator. I can just probe against the rail here. Yeah, next step will be I will probably replace length of string from here to here with a belt. Then I can just drive the belt like with a reduction drive, your typical 3D printer Z, except for no linear rail, no linear motion other than that provided by the 6 cables. And I think it really is a pretty decent mechanism for 3D printers because all of the strings, well, except the one on the bottom that's under the bed, are constrained to 3 sides of the cube. The first side is left open. That's where you would have access to remove your prints. So, and simply tying our 6 cables together into a bunch and rolling them off a roller seems perfectly fine. I will eventually replace this with a machined part, but for now, for prototyping, plastic works just fine. Right, here's my corner pieces. I probably should have just used metal corners, but whatever. And I mean, of course, in the final version, I would not have the pulleys on the outside. I would put everything on the inside. And out of the strings, I contain, like if you're making an enclosed printer, It just like everything runs parallel to the enclosure, doesn't take much extra space at all, probably less than carriage on the rail anyhow. So yeah, and another thing is that like it does, it's not quite as rigid in the XY direction when it is all the way down, but I think that's fixable. I think it shouldn't be an issue once I get better pulleys and put on a thicker string. I can get one that has like 10 times the cross section. That should reduce reduce flex and the load 10 times. Of course, there's another issue at the top. This applies a lot of force. It tries to parallelogram, make a parallelogram out of the big square. And this keeps it from parallelogramming, but not terribly well. They have one of my typical in my builds. Focus. Damn it, it won't focus. Oh yeah, I have a little tightening piece that just uses a screw. The cross beams are just like bolted together from below, nothing special. And this is much a suggestion from 3D Printing Discord. Should give due credit. This diameter matches this diameter, so that it like you don't have to compensate for rope coming off the cable. And another thing is that's interesting that you can run it on either side and run to the matching side here if you need to. So it's convenient. It's actually possible to reroute all the cables so that the top is open. As a suggestion. From the same Discord, from the same person, Igrao, much thanks for that. But I think I'm gonna actually build a printer out of it. I'm gonna install my marionette mechanism up here, and I put a bed on it. And I mean, like there's improvements I could make to this definitely, but even this first build is like it's pretty good. You just imagine how well the first recirculating bows must have worked. I think it's probably not too bad. Right, so with the pulleys, for whatever reason my camera just stops focusing. With the pulleys, I ordered a bunch of better pulleys, but I'm still using TORS because I didn't. It will take forever to arrive. And runout is a little bit critical, otherwise you get Z banding, I imagine. But it just remains to be seen how well the thing prints. Let me run it again for good measure, show you there. And the winch again. Is it moving? Yeah, you can see that it sorry about the camera shake. It takes up a lot of cable at first and then less cable as it progresses down the spiral. Yeah, I wrote a piece of code that computes the shape for an arbitrary function, so you can do whatever function I want. Well, with limits, of course, because it has to be monotonously increasing. The first derivative can't change too fast, and now that just the limitations, but you can get around them with two of those winches if you want to, or the mechanism. And see, the cables are just tied off right there, so the slip is not an issue like in my own designs. I also always tie off the cables, and I mean, everything winds nicely, nothing wants to like overlap. And yeah, Yeah, I think that's about it.